Welcome to a slapshot edition of the Russian Rulers Podcast. I'm your host, Mark Schaus. Today's short podcast is on St. Sergius of Radonezh. Christened Bartholomew, the second of three brothers, St. Sergius of Radonezh was to have a profound effect on the land of Russia. This holy man was to be a major factor in the expansion of the holdings of the Grand Prince of Moscow. He is certainly one of the most revered men of all old Russia. His influence is still felt today. Born of boyar parents, basically a son of a nobleman, his family fell upon hard times as the city they lived in, Rostov, was in the midst of being annexed by Moscow, and its elite citizens were heading downward on the socio-economic path. Ivan I, otherwise known as Ivan Moneybags, was offering tax exemptions to people who would move to a new settlement, a new town named Radonezh. Bartholomew was a mere 7 years old when his parents made the move. This was to be one of a series of traumatic events that was to shape his life. His time in the newborn city was physically trying, but the young boy was far more of a physical child than an intellectual one. His older brother Stefan decided to enter the monastery after his wife died with two young children of whom history has no information about. Shortly thereafter, Bartholomew's parents both died, likely from an outbreak of the Black Plague. He gave the remaining monies that his parents had to his youngest brother and headed out to the forest to find God with his eldest brother Stefan. The single religious experiment that Bartholomew undertook was to have huge repercussions for the lands that were to become Russia. Now, one of the reasons Bartholomew did this was because he had little money, even the money that was left by his parents, with which to enter a monastery. He wanted to very desperately, but was summarily denied. With his brother, though, they built a small hovel to live in and to find their path to God. They wanted out of the world where their labors would be overly taxed by Ivan Moneybags to feed the Mongol overlord. They were also likely to have wanted to flee the plague which was ravaging the cities. They wanted peace. Stefan, though, did not last long in this brutal environment. He could not take the rough living as his brother could. He instead moved back to the monastery of the Apparition, where he would meet their abbot, Alexei, the future metropolitan of the Russian Church. Stefan would eventually rise to the rank of head of the abbot of the monastery, even becoming the personal chaplain of the Grand Prince of Moscow. For Bartholomew, this was not the life for him. He wanted more. He stayed in the forest for more than 2 years. Life was hard both physically and spiritually, but this man of God relished in it. He then had a vision of the devil dressed in Lithuanian style, the style of the Latin West. Words spread about the holy man of the forest as many came to give him food and gifts. Soon more men came to join him. They built hovels to live in and wanted more of the wise man, Bartholomew. But he wanted more than that as he ventured out into the surrounding towns and finally met a monk who was also a priest. Bartholomew shaved his head and asked to be rechristened as Sergius. More and more men came to find Sergius, which forced him to reluctantly create a monastery to hold all the incoming monks. He agreed to merge all the separate hermitages, separate monks' homes, into one large monastery, with Sergius as their head abbot. The year was 1354, and Sergius was only 31. Now metropolitan, Alexei was absolutely thrilled with the expansion of the church, and he encouraged Sergius to expand his vision and to expand his horizons to the vast forests of Russia. So many of Russia's young men were weary of the internecine civil wars, battles with the Mongol horde, and the dreariness of life at the time. It is also highly likely that the plague was continuing to scar the populace as well. Now, lest you think that only men made the moves, women followed them to help farm what little arable land existed. And of course, not all men were capable of celibacy. Monasteries began popping up over the forests, with the church being the owner. Most of the lands were outside any prince's domain, so the holdings of the church were unencumbered. What was happening was the fact that the church was becoming one of the largest landowners in Russia. So large were their holdings that by the mid-1500s, fully one-third of the land known as Russia was owned by the Russian Orthodox Church, and all of this expansion was due to the legacy of one man, Saint Sergius of Radonezh. In 1392, Sergius, who by now was the spiritual head of the church, had inspired Dmitry Donskoy to defeat the Mongols at the Kulikova field, had led thousands of Russians to take the forests of Russia and convert them into monasteries, and was able to stop squabbles amongst quibbling princes with just a word, died. The Holy Trinity Lavra of St. Sergius Monastery he founded was to be a religious and cultural center for centuries and still exists today. It was the, as Ryazanovsky was to say, the fountainhead of a powerful monastic movement. He further goes on to say in his book, A History of Russia, that, quote, the influence of St. Sergius lies in his ability to give a certain reality to the concepts of humility, kindness, and love, which remain both beliefs and hopes of the Christians. Born in 1322, Sergius of Radonezh helped inspire a nation, lead a downtrodden people toward a belief system that gave their life meaning in a meaningless world, and in doing so helped stimulate the Russian expansion that was to last hundreds of years after his death, an expansion that was to make Russia the largest country in the world. St. Sergius is best known for two quotes, both told to Grand Prince Dmitry Donskoy. The first encouraging Dmitry to protect the Orthodox of Moscow from invaders. Quote, with God's help, you shall defeat them. The second, before the Battle of Kulikova Field. Quote, my lord, do not hesitate. March boldly on against a fierce enemy. Fear nothing, for God will help you. Well, I hope you enjoyed today's podcast. Don't forget to visit the websites, RussianRulers.podhoster.com or MarkShouse.com. Leave a comment, ask a question, make a suggestion, and as always, До свидания и спасибо большое.